Angela, my darling, can't believe we have known each other for only half a year and we got so close. You are a very special girl to me. Trust is what I use to describe the relationship between you and me. I never hesitate to tell you anything. You would come to me with your problems about you and your best friends or just anything. I will always be the first to know about you. I've always seen you as a very happy girl and that's what brought us together. Always cheesing and smiling with your mini dimples. We would spend lots of time together, like going to downtown bop around or for workshops and search for jobs, but we never actually had gotten a real one. After school, we'd be getting fat at the Hong Kong style restaurant. We would always order the same things, a dollar fried rice and 50 cents ice cream, please. We never even get to start our New Year's resolution. And I remember how we used to call each other's homies because we would go to each other's houses and eat everything we have until we get full. So it was a normal weekend where we won't be seeing each other for 2 days. This is when the big incident happened. I went to school like a regular day. Your friends come and tell me that you're not here today, that you're at the hospital because you got hit by a car on Saturday while crossing a yellow light to catch the bus. I really didn't know what to say at that moment. I just didn't believe them, not even a little bit. So I went to the cafeteria for lunch and Cindy comes to me and asks, have I heard about it? I was so confused with what is going on. A week later, your parents were asking for all of your close friends to go to the hospital and visit you. My heart dropped when I heard about the news, but I still wasn't crying. I arrive at the hospital and see everybody all crying their eyes out. My mind was blanked out. I was so nervous that I was having butterflies before I went into the ICU room. The moment when I stepped into the ICU room, I was just crushed. I see you sleeping on the bed with bruises all over and your head is bald. That's when my tears start rushing down my face. I held your hand so tight because I knew after today, I won't be seeing you ever again. I was just so shocked to hear how this can happen to you. That one happy girl, always cheesing and smiling. I wouldn't think that would ever happen to me, my close friend leaving my side. Why was what always has come to my mind when I think of this incident? I will always think, is it because you really weren't that important to me? That's why I wasn't crying, or is it just how I deal with things? Even at times when I think of you, I still tend to get watery eyes. But to me, I would step into your shoes and think from your perspective. Because I know you won't want to see me not catching up with life and always being sad and moody or crying myself to sleep. You will always stay in my heart and always be missed by me. I love you, Angela Chen. Sometimes you can't imagine what would happen in the next second. It may feel painful in the beginning, but as time passes by, notice your surroundings and cherish every moment of it. Try talking to someone who is understanding and you can trust very much. You may need lots of support from family and friends, but know that you aren't alone. There is always someone out there for you. Learn from the incident and hope it doesn't happen to you. Always stay hopeful. But what works best for me is just time. It may take a while to cope with it, but as long as you are willing to, nothing is impossible.